Hey guys, in this video I'm going to show you how to create a social media exposure pop-up to reduce cart abandonment. So you start at the dashboard and then click on pop-up. So this is going to be a regular pop-up, so let's leave it as it is. And you can play around with the position and different animation effects that are available on this page. And then click next. You can find the template you're looking for by name or use the different sort by options, which we're going to do. So we're going to use this social media pop-up that has a discount. Let's see it. So this pop-up offers people a 20% discount if they share their order that is in their cart on their social media account and get a discount on their current order. So you can play around with the different options that we have, customization options. You can change the background, you can add a different image, change the text, change the style, change the length of the buttons, and so on. When you're done with that, click next. If your pop-up has any form fields, the management step will give you options to link this the form field to a web app of your choice and submit data to it. We don't have anything in the pop-up, a specific form field, so we don't have anything here. Let's move on. Okay, the behavior step. This is where we'll set up your pop-up's behavior. So a combination of the trigger and the conditions are needed to roll out the pop-up with laser precision. So the first thing is we're gonna do is select inactive. So when somebody has been inactive for, let's say, 2 minutes, but the condition is that they have something in the cart. So now we need to pair the trigger with a condition. Let's expand this section and let's check the box product added to cart and number of cart items added to cart. So you can select either one of them and they will react to whenever something has been added to your cart. You can select a specific product or any product, and here you can select a quantity. So let's select this option and then set up the targeting. Make sure that you specify on which pages or page the pop-up will appear. You can use the and or options to have a really specific targeting. Then finally, you can need to configure the scheduling settings of the pop-up. We recommend that you show it every time that the aforementioned conditions are met. So let's leave it as it is and then click next. Under tracking, you need to check the relevant boxes if you want to track the data from these parameters. So once you're done, click next. Here you can preview what the pop-up will look like on various devices. And finally, you can publish it. So the green button, once it's clicked, your pop-up is ready for action, and that's it. Thanks for watching, and have a good one.